My name is Deborah Salmi, and I work in marketing for Web of Trust. Web of Trust, or WOT for short, was founded in 2006 by two university postgraduate students from Finland. Both worked as researchers in the field of computer security and data mining. During their research, they came up with the idea of creating a reputation system for the web. The goal was to make the internet a safer place for everyone, make it more democratic, and to give everyone a chance to contribute to this objective. The average web user wants to know which websites they can trust. The WOT add-on is a safe surfing tool for your browser. It shows you traffic light style rating symbols that tell you which websites you can trust for safe surfing, shopping, and searching on the web. Many experienced users, they want to contribute to web safety. WOT ratings are powered by a global community of millions of trustworthy users who have rated millions of websites based on their experiences. We had a clear vision of our extension from the beginning. This was our third browser platform. The first version of our extension used a tool strip and a mole for its user interface, but we've had a UI similar to Chrome's browser actions for years now on other browser platforms, and we're very happy to see the Chrome team ultimately decide to go with browser actions instead. Well, integration with our existing service, it was easy. We have a web service API, and we use HTML, HTTP requests to access it from all our other extensions, too. We like the fact that it's easy to reload and test extensions without restarting the browser. Chrome's developer tools were a great help in debugging the extension as well. We would have liked to see some additional APIs for cryptographic primitives, hash functions especially, URL parsing, ID and conversions, for example. So we ended up implementing these in JavaScript instead. Chrome was initially lacking a full internationalization framework, so we decided to implement our own because we wanted to support multiple languages right from the beginning. So later, the internationalization framework Chrome team implemented, it was almost identical to ours. So porting the extension to use it was trivial. It was brilliant, brilliant decision. Chrome's move to use HTML, JavaScript, and CSS to create extensions was a brilliant decision, and it makes developing extensions possible for anyone with web development experience. It's a lot easier to develop extensions for Chrome than for other platforms. Also, the fact that extensions are just web pages, it gives Chrome a natural way to sandbox them from each other and from the privileged browser process. We've had 12 updates since the initial release, and updating the extension through the website, it's really quick and it's convenient, and we especially like the fact that there's no need to wait for a human review before the extension is published to users. So combined with Chrome's automatic extension updates, this makes distributing bug fixes and new features to our users very convenient. And you know, we've noticed that Chrome users are far more likely to use the latest version of our extension than users who have other browsers. Our user community was all abuzz about Chrome, so when the dev channel and then later the beta channel was released, we blogged, we tweeted about it, and many WOT fans tried it out. And because we made sure we were one of the first extensions to be completed for Chrome, many of the respected tech sites included WOT in the must-have list for Chrome. So now, we are working on updating our website and featuring WOT for Chrome more prominently. Part of that is educating users that they have a choice when it comes to browsers, but whichever browser they choose, we want Watt to be part of their safe surfing experience. Developers who are starting work on a Chrome extension, they should carefully think about the architecture of their extension and decide early on what they want in the background page and what should be done in content scripts. If they plan to localize the extension, it's a good thing to prepare for that from the very beginning.
Come meet the Web of Trust team at the Google I/O conference.